All insurance companies globally want to have loyal customers. Loyal customers have a huge economic impact. Loyal customers, particularly promoters who have very positive experience with an insurance company, buy more insurance products, so cross-sell. They stay longer in the relationship, and they even have lower cost in serving them. So if you compare a promoter to a detractor who has negative experience with the insurance company, the lifetime value of a promoter is as 7 times as high as that of a detractor. So that for an insurance company, that means that they have to care for that. Our recent study indicates that in many cases, most of the companies, the insurance companies around the world, do not meet these standards so far, so have relatively low scores in terms of customer loyalty. Only a handful, normally one or two per country, really excel the rest of the pack and are doing an outstanding job. Primarily, they are characterized by doing four things differently. They start with really picking their battles. And picking their battles mean concentrating on certain type of customer segments, understanding the needs, and then really playing with these needs and fulfilling any promises they have made. Then the next step is to selectively invest into moments of truth. The most important moment of truth in the relationship with an insurance company is when a customer is reporting a claim. And it makes a big difference whether a call center agent is taking a script or somebody is educated to really help on the phone, over the phone, and give a complete service to somebody who is just reporting a claim. The next step then is in P&C insurance, and you have to distinguish between the acquisition of a customer that normally comes through price, and then to retain a customer that's mainly driven by the product differentiation and by the services. And it's striking if you see the data of our study that all of the best practice customer loyalty players in all of the countries show a combination of more of these characteristics, normally price plus service. And on the contrary, all of those who are lagging behind normally concentrate on one of these issues. The last point to consider is then being quick in the transformation from the traditional business to the digital business, so combining the traditional physical with the digital business. Because the customers want to have access to different kind of channels, be it electronic ones or physical ones. And our study shows that if you combine these different channels and give the customer the freedom to choose, you have a big upside in customer centricity. So taking these four elements together, that defines the customer journey that will provide you with superior results.